When I was staying around the mall in Champaign, Illinois, I found the most difficult aspects of it all were the black community that were attacking my white life. You see, I had a different type of set of wheels, a really good solid buggy that I found and basically stripped down and made to work for me. But some person, while I was asleep, decided to crunch that buggy so that it wouldn't work for me. They ruined other wheels that were a part of my cooler that allowed me to keep my clothing from getting wet and rained on. You see, a smart mind uses good tools for different things all the time. A foolish mind destroys the life and rights of someone else. When I was near the mall during a time when they did a Black Lives Matter campaign, they didn't march in peace like Martin Luther King. They marched and protested and broke almost everything. Many shops had to replace their windows because of the violence of young people who are fighting in no way for human rights. What they're doing is walking all around in attitude and blackish, which is apparently a form of English that they know and they call each other dude with. But the point is that they were so vile in their soul that their violence still continues to control every situation they walk through, play through, and stay through. I am sad to see that, because there was a particular time of our lifetime and our history of time where we got taught in school how blacks dressed themselves up in quality clothing, the best suits they could for the day, and they marched in loving peace with whites along the way. In lifetime, you have to decide and have to recognize that white people helped the black people to rise. Because if it wasn't for a white judge, if it wasn't for a white group of people listening to their plight, we wouldn't have the same equality rights today that we do. I'm not preaching white supremacy, but I am definitely leaning more towards that clemency every single day. Because the more I see of the illegals here that are violating our rights, stealing our property, fucking our wives without God's rights in them, makes me pissed off in every form of life. The use of audio technology to abuse and torture and make people feel that they're freezing or heating up or overheating or really ready for sex when they're really not ready to do that is immoral behavior here. We have to learn what is what in the technological world, unfortunately, of the rest of the world of the United Nations. Third world impoverished nations are learning technology quickly and using it to abuse us, to demise us, to steal from us and do things to us that is not their lawful right. I am not saying that every person from Asia is a problem. My late spouse and son were not that way. Certainly we had our struggles, but usually they were caused by some white child, some Mexican child, interfering with our rights of parenting of that day. In life, we have moments of time to recognize where our rights for our lives begin and end. And if you're doing one thing to harm another life, to poison a life, to taint food, to be rude, to be foul, to be profane, to tell people off, then you better be prepared to receive the same.